Hi everyone, today I take up a new question from the publication of M.V. Hinship, and this is regarding the stability problems that are part of this publication. In particular, today I take up question number 24 because this was requested by one of the subscribers, and I'm happy to show you how to solve this question using the M.V. Hinship hydrostatic particulars. So before you start this video, make sure you have access to hydrostatic particulars and you can correspond the values that I find from this publication and use it in my calculation. So let's get started with the question. The question is that MV Hinship or motor vessel Hinship is in condition number 7. Note this condition number 7, I'll tell you what it's all about. It pumps out 60 tons of ballast each, all right, each from number 4 double bottom tanks, port and starboard. So you can see I'm highlighting, or I'm circling rather, the important bits of information that is provided to me in the question, because if you get this question in the exam, this is what you should be doing so that you don't miss out on any essential information. Then it says the entire diesel oil in number 5 tank port side is consumed in shifting to the dock. You have to calculate her GM fluid. So my aim is to find GM fluid. GM fluid is a GM on correction of free surface effect, and you have to find the GM fluid on arriving the dock where the relative density, or RD, of the water is 1.007. So you have to make sure that you note down the relative density as well, because the values in the hydrostatic particulars are for the relative density of seawater, that is 1.025. So you have to make certain corrections to the values you find to adjust for this relative density, the dock water relative density, which is 1.007. So let's get started. So to get started, I have to go into the hydrostatic particulars, which forms part of the MV Hinship book or the publication, and I will go into condition number 7. So here we have condition number 7 from the hydrostatic particulars. If you have not accessed it, then pause the video here. Make sure you access the page. It's page number 50. And when you access it, then I will show you some values that you should be focusing on. So the first one you have to focus on is the displacement here. This is the displacement in condition number 7. Why? How I know it's condition number 7? You can see at the top here, it says condition number 7. So at the top here it says condition number 7, at right at the top below the page number, so I know it's condition number 7. And then I go back to highlighting the values. The other value I have to highlight is the kg value, the initial kg at this in this stage here is 7.807. I will also note down the free surface moment, the last column, the free surface moment. All right, I'm going to show you all the values at one go, so that you don't have to go backwards and forwards from the calculation. All right, then we also have number 4 double bottom tanks, port and starboard. Now I have discharged 60 tons each from the port and starboard tanks. So altogether it's 120 tons of cargo, or rather ballast, being discharged. And I will note down the kg of this as well. Now you can see the capacity of the tank is 261.2 tons, but I have loaded discharged 60 tons from each. So that means once I do that, there will be some free surface effect in this tank as well. So I will note down any free surface moment here if it is required. And then we have number 5 double bottom tank for the diesel oil. Alright, so don't confuse it with number 5, any other number 5 tank or hold. This is number 5 double bottom tank port. This is from where you discharge the entire weight. So the entire weight is 17.7, and this is the kg of this is 0.21. And the free surface moment doesn't make a difference here, because if you have completely made this tank empty, then there will be no free surface moment. So free surface moment doesn't exist if the tanks are either completely full or completely empty. It's only when they are partially full that free surface moment or free surface effect is created. So I have noted down all these values. I'll go back to my calculation now. In case I need any other value, and which I can't remember right now, I'll come back to this table and show it to you. All right, so let's go back to the calculation. So my calculation here, you can see here I have taken the initial displacement. The initial displacement is denoted by a triangle. and that is it will be used throughout the calculation. So my initial displacement I took from the table, the initial kg also I took from the table. I will multiply these two values and get the vertical moment, that is the initial vertical moment. Then I have number 4 double bottom tank port and starboard. I have discharged 60 tons each, so number 4 double bottom port is 60 tons and starboard is 60 tons each, so altogether it's 120 tons and I have discharged it, so it will be a negative. So I'll be subtracting it from my initial displacement. I'll be multiplying 120 tons by the kg of the tank, which is 0.68. again, I got these values from the table, so I got all these values from the table, right? And I will be subtracting the 82 tons of vertical moment, 82 metric tons of vertical moment, because I discharged this weight. Then also I have completely emptied number 5 tank port side while I was shifting to dock, and that had a total of 17.7 tons of diesel oil. So that is completely subtracted, so I'll subtract it again from the initial displacement. I will multiply the 17.7 by the kg of the tank and I will make it minus 4. Now remember, when you multiply these values, you may not get whole numbers, you will get values in decimals. It's okay to use the decimal figures if you want to, or you can round it off to the next number and you can go from there. Alright, so don't so if you are multiplying 17.7 by 0.21, you may get a number which is very close to 4. So it has been rounded off to make the calculations easier. Alright, so don't think that you are getting a wrong value in your calculator. Alright, so what I'll do is I'll subtract the initial displacement and I'll subtract the weights that have discharged from the ship, and I will get the final displacement, which is 18391.6. So I will subtract these the two weights that I have discharged from the initial displacement, and I'll get this answer here. And same with the vertical moment, I've got my initial vertical moment. I'll subtract the two vertical moments that have been created by the discharging operations or emptying the tank operations, and I will get my final vertical moment here. So this is my final vertical moment. All right, I'll keep going now. So my final vertical moment is done as well. So to get my final kg, I will subtract the final vertical moment by the final displacement. Alright, and then I get my final kg, which is 7.861 meters. Now my initial free surface moment from the table, I showed you, remember, initial free surface moment from the table, it was in the same row as the initial displacement, initial kg, that was 1552 metric ton for condition number 7. I'll write it down here. Now, because you partially discharge number 4 port and starboard double bottom tanks, you can you will add the free surface moment here, 542, because now the free surface moment has been created. So to the initial free surface moment, you will add this free surface moment. But before you do that, you have to subtract the free surface moment of number 5 port tank, which has been made empty. Now, because initially there was a initial free surface moment of 152 metric ton in number 5 tank, which was contributing to this value here, and now it has been made empty, so there is no more free surface moment from this tank contributing to the initial free surface moment. I will subtract this value, all right, because this value now is no longer adding to the free surface moment, so I will subtract it, because this tank is now empty, so there is no free surface moment. So I got all these values, 152 I got from the table as well. You can go into the row for number 5 tank and you can get that value. This is a free surface moment, 542 is from the table as well, in the same row as number 4 double bottom tank port and starboard, and you take the free surface moment and you multiply it by the density. This is the symbol of density. Density of seawater, which is 1.025, because the tables are all for 1.025 density. So one free surface moment you will add because it has been created due to partial discharge, and the other one you will subtract because the tank has been made empty. So you get your final free surface moment as 1956. So you will take this final free surface moment and find the final free surface correction. So FSC stands for free surface correction, which is equal to final free surface moment, 1956, divided by final displacement. Final displacement is above here. You have the final displacement, 18391.6. so once you do that, you get the final free surface correction of 0.106 meters. Now your vessel was in condition number 7. Here the relative density was not 1.027, it was 1.025. So your relative density was 1.025 in condition number 7. This is where your ship was here. This is the initial situation was this, right? This was your situation. Now as you were shifting to the dock water and shifting to the dock water density of 1.007, you consumed the diesel oil from number 5 tank and you discharged number 4 port and starboard double bottom tanks. This was happening in the process of shifting from seawater to dock water. So when you reached the dock water, the displacement on completion of shifting was 1839, 1.6 tons, which you calculated above. But this displacement is in dock water. In dock water 1.007, your displacement was 1839, 1.6. So to find the values of other hydrostatic particulars in this dock water, you have to convert this displacement into seawater displacement. So you can say that displacement in 1.007 dock water density was 1839, 1.6. So equivalent displacement in 1.025 dock seawater density will be cross multiplication. Just do a cross multiplication here. So 1.025 multiplied by 1839, 1.6. This is of course a question mark, you don't know. Divided by 1.007 will give you the equivalent displacement in seawater. Why do you need equivalent displacement in seawater? It's because you have to find out the other parameters from the hydrostatic particulars, and that is only for seawater density. So although your vessel is now in dock water density, there you are displacing 1839, 1.6 tons of displacement. You are displacing that weight there. But to find the other particulars, hydrostatic particulars, for your further calculations, your aim is to find the GM, right? To do that, you have to convert this, or rather find the equivalent displacement in seawater to work out the values. So therefore, you will use this value and now go to the hydrostatic tables, use a displacement of 18720.3 tons. So I will go into the hydrostatic tables. I will come out of this page here and I will go into this page here. So you can see here for 187. So you can see here, I will show you a couple of things. You can see that all the values are for salt water, specific gravity 1.025, and your displacement will be lying somewhere between here, 18565 and 19051. Am I correct? So because your displacement that you are working with is 18720.3. So 18720.3 will lie somewhere between these two displacement values. So if you have to find any other value such as km, you will take these two values here. That's all. I think you need km because you've got your kg, you need your km values, right? So for displacement of 186565, your km value is 8.352, and for 19051 your km value is 8.388. now you have to use these values, do some interpolation and find out the km value for your displacement of 18720.3, seawater displacement. Alright, so you've got these two values here. So let's do some interpolation. So for a difference of displacement of 486, which is the difference in displacement 19051 minus 18565, so I have subtracted the larger displacement and the smaller displacement. 19051 minus 18565 gives me 486. So for a difference of displacement of 486, the difference in the km value is 0.036. where did I get my 0.036 from? From here. So I have subtracted the two km values, 8.352 8.388, and I have got a difference of 0.036. I have subtracted the two displacement values and I have got my difference of 486. So for a difference of displacement of 486 tons, my difference in km value is 0.036. this is what I know. So for a difference of displacement of 155.3, what is 155.3? 18720.3, which is the required displacement, minus 18565. Alright, so for a difference of displacement of 155.3, what will be my difference in the km value? So again, cross multiplication. this results in this calculation here, 155.3 multiplied by 0.036 divided by 486, which will give you a correction factor of 0.012. So that will be the difference in the Km value. You can see as the displacement is increasing, the Km value is also increasing. So that means as you go from 18565 of displacement to 18720.3 tons of displacement, your Km value will increase. So you will take this value and you will add to this value. So that will be Km of the required displacement in seawater will be 8.352 plus 0.012, because as the displacement increases, the Km is increasing. So you get your final Km of 8.364. You take your final Km, put this here. You have your final kg before that you calculated. Kg is always subtracted from Km to find the gm. This is gm solid, 0.503. Then subtract the free surface correction. Free surface correction is always subtracted from the gm solid, and you get your gm, final gm fluid, as 0.397 meters. All right, so this was the calculation. I hope you understood what we did and why we did, or how I found the values. Otherwise, go back and watch it again, pause it at points that may be a bit confusing for you, and make sure if you have any questions, you can put it in the comment section of the video. I'll try my best to answer it as soon as possible. All right, so I'll keep putting videos on MV hinge shape and stability calculations. If it helps you, let me know if you have any specific question you want me to address. I'll be happy to solve it for you. All the best with your study, guys, and keep in touch.